Veterinary oncology deals with the diagnosis and the treatment of cancer in animals. Cancer is the number one medical concern of pet owners, and it is the leading cause of death in older cats and dogs. My name is Dr. Jerry Post. I am a veterinary oncologist, and this is the Veterinary Cancer Center in Norwalk, Connecticut. Some of the things that I would advise every owner who has a pet to look for would be lumps that are changing in size, shape, or consistency. Enlarged lymph nodes that are present and are not going away. And once they reach mid to older age, I would recommend abdominal ultrasound as well as chest x-rays as screening tests so that if your pet does develop cancer, you can detect it at a much earlier stage. Much of the same common sense recommendations that are made for people are also made for pets. Keeping your pet active, keeping your pet at a healthy nutritional plane, and keeping your pet fit are all incredibly important, whether your pet has cancer or not. Cancers in animals occur the same way that they do in people, and they are affected by the same things. In other words, the environment that they live in, the food that they eat, the water that they drink, and the genetic makeup of the individuals all work together to give every individual, dog, cat, or person, a cancer risk. Many of the drugs that we use in veterinary oncology are the same drugs that are used in human oncology, and so there is an expense to them. We typically use the cancer drugs that are most commonly used for pediatric cancers, and a lot of those are the older, less expensive drugs. Now, with the advent of oral chemotherapy, with low-dose metronomic chemotherapy, we have so many more options available to us than ever before. One of the best studies undergoing right now is the Golden Retriever Longevity Study. And this looks at golden retrievers over a period of the next 13 years to try and find out what are the risk factors that are leading to increased cancer risk. The Blue Buffalo Foundation for Cancer Research and the Pet Cancer Awareness Program have done more to expand people's awareness of cancer in pet animals than any foundation that we've ever worked with. The area of specialty medicine within veterinary medicine is one of the largest growing segments of veterinary medicine. And it really is in response to the desire of the pet-owning public for more advanced testing, for more advanced treatment, and for increased specialization. We now have, again, oral therapies, low-dose chemotherapy, a melanoma vaccine that harnesses the body's own immune system to attack the cancer. We have targeted chemotherapies that are given orally that target particular molecular or genetic defects that are found only within cancer cells. Cancer is not a death sentence. Most cancers are incredibly manageable, and it is rare that we can't do something to increase the quantity and or quality of a pet who is diagnosed with cancer. Having done this for 25 years, the future looks brighter than ever before. There are advances being made in molecular diagnostics, in genomics, in proteomics, that gives me such incredible hope that we will be able to treat and eventually cure the majority of cancers that we see. Now, more and more of the best scientists in the country are looking to comparative oncology, the study of cancers in animals, dogs and cats, for information on how to better diagnose and treat cancers in people. My wish for every animal and every person that leaves here is that they leave here with hope. Hope that we can do something to increase their pet's quality and quantity of life.